Welcome you. Thank you for coming. This is Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Welcome you. Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry invites you to receive your deliverance of salvation, breakthroughs, deliverance from bad dreams, marital problems, business failure, evil family pattern, poverty, witchcraft, and any form of attacks. Welcome once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki. Welcome you. I'm going to talk to you the topic called prayer to break down spiritual evil altars. Welcome once again. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I take the authority in the mighty name of Jesus to bring down satanic altar, every evil altar that has been built in the spiritual realm. I bring them down. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. Jesus, I want to thank you this morning. I want to thank you, Jesus, because you are wonderful and you are worthy. You are powerful than any other gauge, than any other weapon, than any other person, than any other human being around the world, than anything else, God. Jesus, we give all the glory and honor. Jesus, you are wonderful. God Almighty, we thank you. We thank you, our God. We thank you for your power and mighty. We thank you that there is no weapon that is in the world than your word, God. Your word is so powerful. Your word is more than a weapon, God. God, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you that your word is more than a nuclear bomb. Your word is so powerful. It is thunder. It is lightning. It is earthquake. It is a powerful God. I worship you this morning to thank you because of your word. Father, I thank you. As your word says, we would destroy the altars of Satan, evil altars, witchcraft altars, demonic altars. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want to thank you, God, and I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I'm going to read from the book of Deuteronomy 7, verse 5. The book of Deuteronomy 7, verse 5. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Open the book of Deuteronomy 7, verse 5. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Wow. Yes, I'll try. The Bible says, but that says ye, deal with them. Ye shall destroy their altars and break down their image and cut down their groves and burn their graven images with fire. The Lord is telling Moses. God is talking to Moses. He's saying, you have to destroy their altars. The children of Israel, after they have seen the miracles, again they went and built satanic altar. They build spiritual altar. They build evil altar. So these altars they build in their heart. They build altar that become leprous. They build an altar of witchcraft. The altar that they build, they were built altar. You can have an altar in your heart, spiritual altar. That altar, it become rebellious to you. You worship that altar. You worship the idols. So the Lord told Moses, tear it down. Their image, they make cow. They make evil things to worship. So God said, you are going to destroy them. Destroy them, bring them in the mighty name of Jesus. In the book of Judges 6, verse 25, the Bible says, now on the same night, the Lord said to him, take your father's bullock and the second bullock, 7 years old, and pull down the altar of Baal, which belongs to your father, and they cut down the hustler, that is behind it, and build an altar of the Lord your God on the top of the stronghold in an ordinary manner, and take a second bullock and offer a panting offering with the wood of Asherah, which you shall cut down. I pray that God Almighty, in the mighty name of Jesus, will destroy every evil altar, will destroy every satanic altar, will destroy every demonic altar that has been built in your village, in your house, in your community, in your church, in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, God was talking to Gideon. He told him, go and bring down that altar. We are going to destroy spiritual demonic altars in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Gideon was saying, God told Gideon, the altar of his fathers. You see, the altar of his fathers. God was commanded, told Gideon to go and destroy that altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. These altars are also used as remote controlling device to cause problems for people. Some of the wealth things, some of the evil things that they do, including ritual at crossroads in order to limit the victim for life. A person under dominion of these evil altars normally lose his or her mind and can no longer exercise discretion. Such a person will be living in fear and will be experience nightmares and short of affection. In the night of the unwind, the kind of prayer that we on this morning, the kind of prayer that we will pray, it is one to stop this spiritual evil altars. Some people, the victim of spiritual evil altars, they are the ones normally affected with nightmares, or they are experienced huge loss of mind. They can't think properly because somebody is sitting on an evil altar and chanting and speaking against the person. This is spiritual altar. They can go in a spiritual realm and program evil in your heart, in your life. This is a spiritual altar. Some people, they build in their heart. I pray that the Lord will destroy this evil altar. We bring them down in the name of Jesus. I'm going to talk about crossroad altars. This is prevention of the cross of Jesus. Crossroad altars is the cross of Jesus or crossroad. The reason they use crossroad is to summon demons for north, south, east, and west. The altars called crossroad altars. It is the altars that they summon people from the east, south, west, and north. When they call people from the south, somebody is standing and they call this altar and they cast out. For example, you drive in the crossroad where they say crossroad. You have no idea what is happening that. And then you hear the car, bam, accident. People die, bloodshed. Those are evil, spiritual evil altar they are built there. You don't see by your eyes, but there is a spiritual evil altar they are built there. That's why you breathe the blood of Jesus on the road when you are driving. When I was in England, I was driving a very clear road. There was nothing. You cannot say anything that there was nothing there. And then my front tire passed. And then I went self-accident. I hit the pavement. The car rolled me. That car was finished completely. I came out. Everybody was shaking their head. Says, is there somebody come out of this car? It was in the newspaper. It was the TV. Everybody, everywhere. Helicopter came to control the traffic because there was a huge traffic. I'm telling you, crossroad, it demon in the spiritual where they are programmed the evil, they cause it's a black spot. They kill people there like crazy. I pray that God will destroy every satanic crossroad in the name of Jesus. It is because they are summoning demons to cause horror in the place. Wherever is victim of crossroad altars will be bombarded with affliction. Any born again believer who does not know his or her light and lack power can encounter the effect of evil altars. A policeman on the road controlling the traffic may stop a vehicle because of his authority that he has. A policeman, when he is in a uniform, he can control the roads, he can control you and do you everything he wants because he is in uniform and you have to obey the authority. Once a child of God has been given authority, your authority is not like a policeman when he has his uniform. You have your authority, you have this authority with you all the time. Therefore, you must know your rights and your authority you have in Jesus. So when you are in the road, make sure you bleed the blood of Jesus over the road. As next month, we are going to start Ember Month, a very dangerous month that we are facing. Many people would die and would face a lot of tragedy. So I pray that God would deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you. If you are powerless, then you cannot be able to control these crossroad demons. They are summoning people from four corners. They are from south, east, north, west. They call and they summon people. We have the one which we call three altars. This topic is in my class. We have deliverance class, school of deliverance, a training school. So I am talking, just the students who have been going through this, they are aware what I'm talking about. So I want you to join the school of training, the school of deliverance and healing ministry, so that you can learn a lot of stuff about the deliverance. Now, the altar, the three altars, we know that some people put sacrifice some by some trees. For example, they go and sacrifice and put this, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, this is my notes I'm using this for the class. So my students, you can help me. I don't know if I'm going to do it well because I don't see properly some things I might miss. And the classes is gone. I don't know where it has gone. God knows. I pray that I ask God to show me where it is. Yes, Lord, thank you. These are the altar the evil priestess and the powerful native doctor have wept with white piece of cotton, piece of cloth to wipe on the tree. Now, when they tie you the piece of tree on this altar, for example, papaya, banana tree, sacrifice found at the tree altars are usually used wrapped with white clothes. That's why a report is filed against a person and a case of such a person is handed over to the demons living in the tree, including witches and wizards. Before a sister got born again, there was a sister who got born again, and she became a demonic prophetess who lay hands on people while she prophesied upon their lives. She told a story of how she attended a church carrying out a demonic assignment as usual. But a woman sitting beside her challenged her, claiming that she had a great power. You know, these are the psychic prayers. When people like that, they have these demons, even false prophets, they use this a lot. This altar tree. So you have to understand these altar trees. Now, the woman touched her legs and as a result of them were left away from the church and land in a cavern within a rock. This, they saw various kind of modern gadgets like refrigerator. These are the form of an tree, an altar, and I call it at three altars. At three altars, when it is wept, the clothes, and then they put your stuff there. You can be, people can pray, but the power, they are hanging in that tree. So that's why you need to have spiritual inner eyes to see where the altar they are building, satanic altar, evil altars. Then you fire prayers straight to that trees, and then that demons that are planted there, they will catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Yes, we thank God for that. It happened in a spiritual realm. You have no idea what the enemy do. There is photograph altars. Altars can be constructed with wedding photographs, family and individual pictures. Through that person will begin to receive tormentment and affliction, or may even get killed. These photograph altars, you see people taking all pictures. They get your pictures from Facebook, everywhere, even your birth certificate, they can get some information there. That's why you see many marriages are break up because of these wicked satanic photograph altars. So you as a child of God, you have power. You command your photos wherever they are to catch fire and burn to ashes. People are so wicked. Some people are so wicked and evil. This is what they do. You see, if you have been praying, and the satanic and the evil people have taken your photos to satanic altar. So you pray that God, in the name of Jesus, I take my pictures, my photograph pictures, wedding pictures that is in the evil altars, I burn them to ashes. You command that altar to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God. You send fire. I pray that witchcraft, they are so wicked and evil, they know how to do this. And this all is spiritual. It is things of evil, spiritual altars. I know my sister, Mary, she was telling me how a witch sent her photograph and everything to manipulate and control her. I prayed for her. I destroyed the pictures and the certificate and all the information she gave to this person because she was looking for help. And this person pretended she became like a woman of God or a person of God that can pray. But the lady was surprised that when this woman was talking and she demanded a lot of money from her. I pray that you will not give a witch your photo to manipulate you, to control you in the mighty name of Jesus. Anywhere where your photograph is, your picture, your birth certificate, your information in the coven, in the altars of satanic altar, I set them fire. I pray that let God send fire and burn them to ashes. It is not going to manifest. It is going to not to stand. No weapon formed against you shall prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray wherever your photograph is, wherever your birth certificate is, every any honor on your point of contact, you give people because you need help. You needed help. Pastors ask you the photos of your family. You give them because you needed help. And then they go and put in a photograph altars where they will construct evil against those pictures. I set them fire. I destroy them. Your marriage will be restored. Some of your marriage, your pictures are in the photograph altars. Your marriage is going to be restored in the name of Jesus. Yes, I pray that God will destroy that pictures wherever they are in Jesus' name. We have what we call image altars. These image altars, symbols are made represent a person or something in the spiritual world. And whatsoever they do to that symbol may happen to the person in the spirit. For example, if they give the head a terrible blow, the person may begin to have several headache. And this explains why some students certainly take heal during the examination. Also, a soap can be constructed to represent the really soap of a person. Wherever they do, that image will happen to the soap in Riri. So these are the image. They represent image altar. They are symbols of represent a person, something in the spiritual world. And then something they can you can hear somebody feeling a headache. A headache, you can be killed. Somebody starts complaining headache when you are rushed to hospital, dead. They do a lot. They started doing that. They attack your head. Even when you are about to do exam, I was talking with a doctor. Anytime this doctor wants to go to do examination, the test, he will feel headache and he will strike a very heavy headache, and then he feels sleep all the time. This is image altar. Image altars. These are the ones representing you. And then the person will be coming. You have headache all the time, very severe headache. That is the image altar. Reporting altars. This is kind of altar where the name of a person is chanted at times. Victim of reporting altars will be hearing their names without knowing who is calling them. However, if they answer, immediately they fall beat. These reporting altars, some people, there are people with the schizophrenia, or people with the mental challenging, but sometimes it can be, you are normal, you have no problem, you don't have anything, you just hear somebody calling your name. You responded, even at night when you are sleeping or when you are sitting. You just hear very clearly somebody calling your name very clear, and you don't see this person. Now, when you respond immediately, you will become the plate. You will become a meat of that person. Immediately, you will get sick. You become crazy. They chant. That's why you see so many people become crazy. A person start doing their own stuff because of these reporting altars. So I pray that every reporting altar formed against you shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy them and I bind them, I break them, I bring them down in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want to talk to you another altar called clothing altars. This is a clothing altars. Clothing altars. This is a case where evil people lay hands on the clothes of their victim for evil purpose. You have heard some people saying green handkerchief, poor did handkerchief, poor did avrons. So Satan knows Satan knows the power in the cloth. So even the mountain of Elijah. So now people knows that even these clothes from Israel, people get this. It is a cloth. Let me show you. I don't know. I want to show you examples so that you can know what I'm talking. The clothes that has power, they put the clothes, they dedicate that cloth to evil, to clothing altars, and they chant and speak over that cloth, and then the victim of evil purpose. So if you know that somebody had cut off a portion from any of your clothes, or your underwear was once stolen, or clothes got mysterious, you may need to embark on aggressive prayers. Now, this altar, the purpose of these evil altars, they want to put a problem to the person. That's why you see the enemy is a counterfeit. They always steal things of God. I'm not saying that these clothes does not work, but there's an evil ways the enemy is using. In a spiritual way, they put these altars and they sell to people. People, they buy them, they have no idea. They think that this clothes is powerful, it will help. You must know what the person is selling to clothes, what the kind of the person is. Is he a child of God or is he a child of the devil? Is he a cult? Is he a child of that? Is he a Lucifer? Is this a devil? You don't have to grab to for inferences. You go to get order those handkerchief, and you don't know where they are coming from. You can buy a problem by yourself. If you have such a handkerchief and you have no idea where they come from, throw them away. Put them in the garbage. Cut them into pieces and throw them away. Some people, even they have the links. Satanic ring, but I'm not talking about the ring. I'm talking about clothing altars. This is a case where evil people lay hands on the clothes of their victim for evil purpose. So evil purpose, you will become, everything become bad luck. Everything become evil. Nothing will work for you. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I have to stop here. I'm going to talk to do some prayer. We have so many altars. You join the class of deliverance, school of deliverance and healing. You will learn about the altars. You will learn about how you can interpret dreams. There's a lot of stuff in the school of deliverance and healing. So I ask you, if you have not joined, we will start the class again next month, the month of September. So the class will start. I pray that God will help you. How can we deal with evil spiritual altars? Recognize their oppression, which you have had. Repent of those things in your life that are giving evil altars platform to prosper in your life. Renounce them. It does not matter whether you know about them or not. They are a spiritual thing. You don't know what you have to renounce them. Resist them using the word of God. Kill the priest of evil altars who are being used against you. Kill them. Command the fire of God to consume them. Destroy evil altars. Give the priest God. Destroy them. I am praying for you now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I am praying. Let the earth shaken and trembled, and also the hills, their foundation, let them be moved and shaken because of God is wrath. Let the channel of the wicked waters be shaken and their foundation exposed at the press of their nose, as the press of their nose, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that, oh God, rebuke every evil foundation, every satanic altar, cast them unto the sea and out of the way forever in the name of Jesus. Oh God, break down every evil foundation, every evil spiritual altars, I break them down in the mighty name of Jesus. Break every satanic altar. Break every evil spiritual altar in the name of Jesus. Break and destroy their purpose. Break them and destroy them in the name of Jesus. The power of ignorance holding you captivity and preventing you from destroying your evil altars or your foundation, I command them to loose in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that you would overcome by the blood of Jesus every satanic foundation and the prison building against you to evil altars from your father's house and which you have, it has stolen you in one way or the other. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I want you to decree destruction to every household enemy, evil foundation resisting your promotion and the breakthroughs in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree by the degree of heaven, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I am speaking to evil altars. Evil altars holding your blessings, evil altars, in the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy you. I destroy you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I strongly command every voices calling your name in for evil. I command that voice to be withered in Jesus' name. I command that voice to be withered in the mighty name of Jesus. I am speaking the word of the living God. Every satanic voices, evil voices calling you for evil, let that mouth to be withered in Jesus' name. Let them broke their teeth and break it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Altars, it is not sufficient for people to call the Bible, walk along the streets as children of God or born again if they have had nothing to do with the altar of the devil. In the name of Jesus Christ, who paid your price at the cross of Calvary, I boldly break every link, contact you have had with the demonic world through the altars in Jesus' name. I pray every evil altars calling out instruction from your evil foundation to hinder you be set fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is the Lord. It is the Lord that has given you power to make wealthy, Therefore, I paralyze and destroy evil altars and their spells working against your finances and a good living in the mighty name of Jesus. It is God's power to make you wealthy. It is the power of God to make you wealthy. Silver and gold belongs to God. God is the owner of all the money. God is the owner who owns silver and gold. Therefore, every satanic altar holding your finances, attacking your finances, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I destroy evil altars. Altars that is crying against your finances. Satanic altar speaking evil against your business. Satanic altar speaking evil against your marriage. Satanic altar speaking evil against your children. Satanic altar speaking evil against your promotion. Satanic altar speaking against you, against your husband. Let their mouth to be withered in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak, let their tongue to be cut to pieces in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. You have to reverse and renounce those altars. In the mighty name of Jesus. I declare and decree by the power and the blood of Jesus, you shall not be a victim of these evil satanic altars. I am bringing them down. I dismantle them in the mighty name of Jesus. I dismantle every evil spiritual altars built in your life. Even you yourself, you can build an altar and you have no idea. I am bringing that altar wherever it is, where they are hiding. Whether they are in your father's house, whether it is in your house, whether it is in your family, in your churches, I am sending the fire of God to burn them to ashes. I am sending the bulldozer of God to go and pull them down in Jesus' name. Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name and give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any stone or abnormality programmed into your spirit, soul, and body by occult altars, be completely destroyed and evacuated in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, I stand on your word and the authority in the name of Jesus Christ to command withdraw all your vultures locked up in the evil altars. Let those vultures come out in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy and bind out every evil altars built in your life in Jesus' name. Let this be known to the altars that you are drinking the blood of Jesus and you have swallowed the fire of the God to patch a system clear in Jesus' name. Let this altar know that you are drinking the blood of Jesus. Let this altar know, the evil altars know that you have the blood of Jesus. You have the power of God. You have the word of the living God. Those altars will not function in Jesus' name. I want to thank God. I bless him and I give him the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you once again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God, I give all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. My God, I want to thank you once again. Oh, Lord, I stand on the word of God to command the demotion of all the satanic gates in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. I stand with the word of God. Demolish all satanic altars building in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you. I want to give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. I want to stop here. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Please, if you have not joined the class of deliverance and healing school, join. We are taking a student next month and it will be fun. There's a lot of things you can learn. You learn about the package of the altar, how you can build your own altar, how you can stop this satanic altar. And there's a lot of stuff, how to hear the voice of God about the witchcraft. There's a lot of stuff you need to run from spiritual warfare, deliverance school. If you have not, you can go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. There's information there. Look at that information. And if you have any question you want to join, call me. Also, you can call me. Our number is 647-608-5207. I have a package here, the altars. I have so much information that I can teach you. God will help you. I have marriage counseling package also. If you want to become a marriage deliverance minister for marriage counselor, I can teach you. We teach marriages. Your marriage will never, never, never experience any evil arrows once you go through that package of counseling. Some of us, we didn't go through such a counseling. That's why the enemy has get access to take away our husband, divorce. When you go to this marriage counseling, even married couples right now, if you need this counseling, you call me. I will help you. I have so much information that many people, they have no idea about it. God is good. So call me. I will help you. And if you have any question about the other, the topic we have gone, you can call me and I will explain it for you. Call us. Our number is 905-487-7196. This is our landline. And the cell phone number is 647-608-5207. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Tomorrow, Sunday service, 8 o'clock. I hope all will go well and I will come up with a new topic. The Holy Spirit will give me, I don't know what I'm going to talk tomorrow, but the Holy Spirit knows. And I thank God that God is awesome God. He's a wonderful God. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful time. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. See you. I love you so much and there's nothing I can do about it. Amen. Amen. Bye, 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 bye. Bye.